It's literally amazing. And especially right now, you already can build, with the same code base, a mobile app, website, and desktop app. So in one of the projects I was building the Mac app, it's really amazing. It's such a such a lifesaver. It's insane. So I think only this aspect, it would be just hard to kill a Flutter, to kill Flutter. So I don't really think that, it will die. Everything can happen again. Maybe Facebook, releases something, some, React Native on steroids with some similar vision. Yeah, not sure.
Do you think that React Native people are starting to take a look at Flutter too and maybe will consider to start to switch over?
This is actually very interesting. If I was React Native developer, which I'm not, but if I was, I don't think I would look into Flutter. I think it's, if I already build, significant amount of technical expertise in React Native, I don't think I need to invest my time in a Flutter. I think now, because maybe in a couple of years, when the trend of React Native might die, like when you see decline in the trend of React Native, maybe then there is a good indication now that okay, maybe there is a time to switch the framework which I'm working on, because again, this is kind of opportunity cost, and if I spend 5 years in React Native to achieve the same level in Flutter, I'll need several years. Can I really sacrifice several years, or I can continue, getting better on React Native for a couple of years and earn, sick amount of money? So it's again, it's pros and cons. Of course, you can, have a look into Flutter. You can play with it, but to really, be in Flutter's eco, you really have to build stuff. Because that's also actually I can share one of the observations from my side. If the developer is like, let's say, if the person has 10 plus years of development experience, let's say native IS, right? And they switch to Flutter. So it's still, you'll be Flutter junior because it's just fundamentally different how everything works. It's the same if you're 10 years of Android and you switch to Flutter. So it's, you can clearly see in the code that the person, they have very, very good technical skills. Like they have tons of experience and how they are building the app, how they are decoupling the app, how they are modeling their app, the whole model structure. It really screams that the person has experience. But from Flutter side, how state management works and how things are putting together, it just, you can look into it and think, what the hell, is this other person wrote this? Because again, Flutter is, it's just so different from these native from native languages. And I think, yeah, this is also the thing. And of course, for mobile to catch up with Flutter, it will be also easier than for a person coming from web, because I think of even the naming is quite similar, especially if you go from Android to Flutter, because it's the Google. But again, there is quite a learning curve, because you're stepping, if you are in Android, you're stepping from Kotlin or Java to Dart. If you're in IS, you're stepping from C or Swift to Dart. So you also need to understand how Dart works, and there are tons of tips and tricks on Dart, list management and etc. Extensions, yeah, lots of different stuff, and especially right now, not safety. So, yeah.